Hi, this is Scott Garibay, and today I'm going to be talking about Dungeons & Dragons 5th Edition, and I'm specifically going to talk about the question, is your game a serious game? Alright, so the reason why we're talking about this is this question like became a very stark reality in our game recently. So I run a very unusual game. We play of Dungeons & Dragons 5th Edition. We play an Omni Dungeon Master game, so we play every Sunday, we play every Sunday. We play two sessions. Session one is a 2-hour block from 6 to 8. Session two is a 2-hour block from 8 to 10. And then there's a spin down time from 10 to 11 p.m., right, where everybody can just like kind of shoot the breeze and kind of spin down and things like that, right? So basically, the Omni DM path is one dungeon master runs and every other person at the table is a DM when they're not is a player when they're not dungeon mastering, and then when it's their turn to dungeon master, and we switch off every session, right? So basically within two Sundays our four player dungeon masters, everybody will have one session as a dungeon master and three sessions as a player character, right? So we're playing, and it's very challenging, right? Because there's two things that are happening. So one thing, there's proof that people love the game, because here's my proof that people love the game. It's hosted at my house, right? And several times work has gotten in the way, and we ran eight sessions, we're good to go. I'm glad this lasted as long as it did. You know, we're going to lose two of our players. Let's shut this down, right? And players are like, no, no, no. Listen, I'll reschedule my work. That's big. I take that really seriously, right? And they did. We found nights, and we have a schedule that allowed everybody to play. The other thing I said, hey, I want to bring in new players, right? And everybody at the table was like, this is rock solid. We don't want another person added, right? Now, I'm a little bit ashamed of that, right, because I know how hard it is to find good games, and now my game is one of those games that shuts people out, right, like, it's just the way it is, right, and by the way, and I do get what they're saying, because we really got, this is very challenging running a game where everybody's dungeon mastering and everybody's playing, right. Now, the other thing is, we take a story and pick up the next, so basically, what you would think would happen is that one person would continue where for the other people are continuing from. That's true. All the player characters are the same, okay? And each of the non-player, and when the DM, they don't run their own player characters. We have them shuffle off into a space that is not, we have them get out of the way, okay? In America, a lot of times, if people want to take a break, they'll go down to Mexico and, just kind of vacation, right? Same thing. We're like, when you're dungeon mastering, we don't want your player character, saving the day. Get them off screen, right? This is for real player characters, not your player character being run by you as a DM, right? So we don't accept that noise, right? So one of the things that happened recently is, and what most DMs are doing is they're running adventures that can be encapsulated in one adventure with just one or two, with maybe just the city being the connecting note, right? Very rarely does a dungeon master pick up an adventure that another DM left laying there, right? What they generally do is they run whatever they're excited about, and they use their power as a dungeon master to move the player characters into position. Right, to do that, whether it's with dimension gate or whatever, magic or just time acceleration, whatever is necessary, right? But the game is going really well, right? Everybody wants their seat at the table. Nobody wants anybody added, and people are moving their schedules, right? And we're up to around like 15 sessions now, so I think this thing is on rails. We're doing it, and people are happy, right? So recently, we had this really interesting question where basically, We were debating on, hey, what happens when we set a non-player character in place? Is it fair game to do anything with that non-player character for the next dungeon master, or should we stop at the death of that? Like, no one DM should be able to kill an NPC that another DM established, right? So this question, right? And so one of the players was like, well, yeah, of course, right? We should be able to kill the NPC. And the reason why is this isn't a serious game, right? One of the players said this at the table, right? So immediately I perked up and I was like, what do you mean this isn't a serious game, right? Like, now, first of all, I understand. I'm an intense, adamant guy, right? Like, I do a lot of eyebrow management, right? Like, you know, and so, like, I can be expressive, right? And so, you know, so, and honestly, you could tell, like, I did not raise my voice in any way. I didn't curse. But you could tell I was like, what are we talking about here? Like, you know, right? And the person goes, and they're like, well, you know, each story is encapsulated. We're not carrying, you know, this story from that story to this story. And I said, well, I want you to be very aware. This is a very serious game. And honestly, you know, we're at 15 sessions. You know how long the average D&D campaign is? It's 6 sessions long. We're at double the rate, right? And frankly, I'm getting so excited about this game that I have an 8th level character right now, and I think we have the possibility that one of us is going to hit 20th level, right? I've never run a character to 20th level in my entire life, right? I want that. I want that for somebody at this table, if not everybody at this table, right? This is a very serious game, right? And so that's what I said with my words, right? And then I was quiet, right? And the player got it, right? And one of the things I was, you know, that I always have in mind, and I'm like, if you don't think this is a serious game, honestly, it ain't going to be hard to replace you at this table, right? All right, so there, and, you know, because the reality is, there are people taking it very seriously. I got, you know, one of the guys shows up a half an hour early and is, like, unfolding maps so that when the other people get there at 6, like, we're ready to roll, right? Like, you know, I take this very seriously, right? Right? Like, it's not uncommon for me to put 2 days of prep into, you know, I might take, though, I usually don't, yeah, so at minimum, I'm going to take one week night and give that to the game, and then the game is at Sunday at 7, right? I might get home from church at 1 and blow the whole rest of the day out just prepping if I have a DM slot there. That's serious, right? That's 4 to 7 hours of prep for game time that's going to be 2 hours, right? And that night, we have a 5-hour block of time, including the spin-down time, that we're dedicating. That's serious, right? And the reality is, I don't play with any, you know, everybody in my group, they got real lives, right? They got 50 things they could be doing, right? So the question is your game a serious game, right? And I think you need to ask yourself that. And if the answer is no, you might want to ask why. And what can you do to make it a serious game? And the reason why is, again, this question of where are we taking Dungeons & Dragons? The goals I have for Dungeons & Dragons, I want Dungeons & Dragons 5th edition to surpass every single board game in popularity, revenue, time spent, people playing it, right? And frankly, I want it to be the A number, and I want more people playing Dungeons & Dragons 5th edition than Fortnite. That's my goals, right? That's the goals that I have for Dungeons & Dragons 5th edition. Now, my ability to make those goals happen is my engagement with the Dungeons & Dragons community and the link between what the Dungeons & Dragons community can get Wizards of the Coast to change, right? And first of all, if you don't think Wizards of the Coast can't be changed by a D&D community, you're not paying attention. It was just proven in Wild Beyond the Witchlight when they had 3 books that had no alignment, and then they brought alignment back in Wild Beyond the Witchlight. That proves that they are listening. The idea that Wizards of the Coast doesn't care what their customer thinks is ludicrous. They do more to attach the reality of the game to what the player base is saying than any other company in all of tabletop role-playing games, right? So, you know, so I think that's the best way to say it. I want more people playing Dungeons & Dragons 5th edition at a higher rate, higher frequency, and with more joy than people play Fortnite. When that happens, I'll tone it down. I'll back it off, right? And say, okay, yeah, we're where we should be. Until then, you know, I want to move and adjust the Dungeons & Dragons community to make sure it's making its request known and doing the things it needs to do to make that goal a reality, right? And the way we get there is we take our games very seriously, okay? Now, of course, there's going to be laughter at the table. And this is another thing, is I really dislike comedy tabletop role-playing games. And the reason why is you don't need a comedy tabletop role-playing game. If you take your game as serious as you possibly can, one of your knuckleheads is gonna say something so funny that you give them inspiration, right? Like, it happens in, you know, the best tabletop role-playing game comedy games is the game you're running right now. Like, you always, you know, there's just so many, you know, fun things, there's so much joy at the table, you're going to get that laughter. So when I say take it seriously, I mean, like, when you're dungeon mastering, make sure you're pouring in the time to be prepped and be ready. When I'm saying you're a player, make sure you are understanding that that player character is an extension of you, right? And that you need to be making that player character's life better, and that player character needs to be making your life better, right? On Saturday when you play, you are going to make the best choices you can for that player character. On Sunday through Friday, that player character is going to echo in your mind and in your heart and in your spirit and say, hey, are you exploring? Hey, are you interacting with people? Hey, are you combating the weaknesses that are in you? Right? It's once you start down the Dungeons and Dragons life path, it never ends, right? We make our player characters the best they can be in that fantasy world, and they make us the best we can be in this IRL real world. That's what it means to take the game seriously. Are you taking the game seriously as a dungeon player? Are you taking the game seriously as a dungeon master? If you're not, I'm calling you to it. I'm calling you to it. That's my opinion. What do you think? Do you think I'm right that, you know, that our interaction with our player characters when we're playing the game correctly, when we're hearing Gygax call with his legacy from the grave, it means that we decide for the player character and on Saturdays, but we are impacted on Sunday through Friday by that player character. That hero we play, call, you know, on Saturday in a fantasy world, calls us to be a hero in the IRL every other day of the week. And that if we're not doing that, we're not really honoring Gary. That's my take. I'd love to hear your thoughts. Let me know in the comments below. Please consider liking and subscribing. Have a wonderful millennium.